Have you heard about Kai, the hitchhiking hatchet hero?
This dude went from this heroic, beautiful person to wanted for murder.
An absolute bizarre scene here in West Fresno. A man plows his car into a PG&E worker, pinning him against his truck.
Two women are trying to help him. He runs up and he grabs one of them, man. So I f***ing ran up behind him with a hatchet. Smash, smash, smash.
Welcome back to DMR. Thank you for tuning back in. Much obliged. So I hope you did check out my review for The Gray Man, starring Ryan Gosling and also Chris Evans as well. Good old fashioned action film out on Netflix. So go and check that one out if you haven't done so already. So today I will be reviewing a documentary that came out. It's a documentary movie, not a series. So it's called The Hatchet Wielding Hitchhiker. Bit of a mouthful of a title there, about some events that took place about 10 years ago in the USA with a gentleman named Kai. So let's go through this very interesting and bizarre story. But before we do, let's go over our main sponsors, which is Pure Spectrum and of course the good old folks at Manscaped. And we return to the Pure Spectrum Farm. So as we can see up on the screen, their amazing line of products. We've got the CBD oil in the blue bottles, gummies, creams, you name it. It's all there on their website, so be sure to jump on it and check it out. So the team at Pure Spectrum, their mission is to improve the quality of life by connecting people to the healing powers of the hemp plant. So they've also got the Pure Spectrum Black Label that I did receive in the mail a couple of weeks ago. As you can see there up on the screen, the two blue bottles there and the Pure Spectrum Black Label. I do use it after the gym. So amazing products there. The 15% off code is DEWYCBD. That's DEWYCBD. You can see it there on the screen. So it works store-wide. So be sure to jump on the Pure Spectrum website. Fantastic range of products, all with the healing powers of the hemp plant. So thank you for the team at Pure Spectrum for their goodies. Cheers. So I hope you enjoyed your Valentine's Day and your package was ready and it went off with a bang. But we don't stop there, do we, ladies and gentlemen? No, no, we don't. So as you can see up on the screen here, we are back with the Platinum Package 4.0. We've got the Lawnmower version 4.0. Awesome little charging station there. Comes complete with a LED 4000K spotlight. Very handy if you are trimming in the dark. We've also got the deodorant there. You've got the Crop Preserver and the Crop Reviver, part of my daily hygiene routine. We've also got the amazing smelling body wash there. The 2-in-1 shampoo, so that is very handy. Really cuts down the time there. You gotta love a 2-in-1 special. All of this comes in the Shed travel bag. Very handy to haul all of your goodies around. Plus you've got the magic mats as well. So 20% off, guys. That's 20% off using the code on the screen there, which is DEWY20. That's DEWY20. And this does work store-wide as well. So they've got an amazing range all up on the screen there. They have got the beard trimmer over in the USA now, so that's very cool as well. So thank you to the guys at Manscaped. Yeah. So the Hatchet Wielding Hitchhiker. So this took place in 2013 in the US of A. So it's a 15 minutes of fame story or documentary about this guy called Kai. So he's a bit of a fun-loving hipster surfer type dude, bit of a nomad. So he's traveling around all the time. So he doesn't really have a home. I'm not sure if he is homeless. He seems more of a nomad. Basically seeking out the kindness of others to help him go about his way and whatnot. So there is an accident with a guy pinning somebody else against a pole and the driver of that vehicle tries to get away or some fight breaks out and Kai is a bystander or a witness and just happens to have a hatchet or a small axe with him. He goes over to this driver that's trying to get away and starts hitting him over the back of the head with the back of the hammer, and apparently it was on the front of the hammer as well with the sharpened axe front. So the guy didn't die, survived. Anyway, so he basically gets interviewed by a local news crew and he starts to do smash, smash, smash when he's telling the story, and he seems like a pretty fun dude, and basically he goes viral completely all over YouTube. He gets turned into memes. He gets turned into remixes for the Smash, Smash, Smash and all that. So he goes Billy Bananas in terms of him going viral. So off he goes back to his nomad lifestyle, and everyone is just obsessed with this Kai. So that's basically the first part of the documentary, and now it's up to a few people to basically track down this guy and see if they can get some more content out of him.
Everyone around the world wanted a piece of this kid.
How do you know this guy?
The internet, man.
Is that really you?
How did it make you feel though, being this viral sensation?
I'm not a virus, I'm a sensation, I'm Kai.
Most people that are heroes are not homeless people. There was something funny about him, and kind of cute and sweet and innocent.
He has such an endearing quality. There's so much charisma.
So now that he's gone viral, everybody wants a piece of Kai. So they're trying to track this guy down, some Hollywood talent scouts or people that work for the likes of Jimmy Kimmel. They're after him to get him on the show and get more good times and more funny one-liners and whatnot out of him, but it's very hard to track down someone that's a nomad or homeless. It's like looking for a needle in a stack of needles, especially with the population of the US of A. So although it's a hard task, they do find him, they finally get a hold of him, and one of the producers or something along those lines has him stay at her house. Then they go to a hotel room in the LA area, and basically they start to witness some odd things that Kai does. He's jumping all over the beds like a spoiled little toddler. He's grabbing anything from the minibars, sculling it down, and they're all just in awe of what they're basically witnessing, thinking that what the hell have we done? Who the hell is this guy? Why are we doing what we are doing? But parking all that aside, he finally gets to the Jimmy Kimmel show, and he's on there with Jimmy Kimmel. He's making some odd, funny type remarks. Jimmy's kind of playing with him a bit. He does that quite well. Then they give him a gift, a surfboard, at the end of the show, and he's reached the top of his 15 minutes of fame. However, after that point, we do see it start to decline. So like all 15 minutes of fame, once you're up, it starts to come down, and it comes down very, very hard and lands Kai as a suspect for murder.
Before I say anything else, I want to say no matter what you've done, you deserve respect. Even if you make mistakes, you're worthwhile.
If you're going to glorify someone, you better know who you're glorifying.
Kai, the hatchet-wielding hitchhiker, he's been arrested for allegedly taking the life of a man in New Jersey.
There was no forced entry, but under the computer is a phone number with the name Lawrence Kai. Made you stop and think, could he be responsible for something like this?
So now we bear witness to the decline of the 15 minutes of fame. So people are still taking selfies with Kai. He's also got people with t-shirts about the young man. So on his nomad travels, he comes across a 74-year-old lawyer, I think it is, a Caucasian white lawyer. He's brought into the lawyer's house, and then all of a sudden, this lawyer basically turns up dead, murdered, bludgeoned over the head, and the last person that is seen with this lawyer is Kai. So apparently he is captured on CCTV footage. We see that in the trailer and in the documentary, and it's a very bizarre circumstance because people are trying to catch up with Kai now because he's a main suspect, the cops that is, and they finally catch up with him. He has shaved his head, so all of his hipster style hair is now gone. His tattoo is very noticeable on his face, and he is now under arrest. So we then go to the CCTV footage in the cop shop, and he's being interviewed by the cops, starts talking about the murder, some aspects of the murder, then stupidly says, I need a lawyer, once he's kind of blurted things out. But he is then put on trial and he's found guilty. And they basically said to him, the judge that is, that on the surface you're nice and bubbly, but behind closed doors, you are a cold-blooded killer. And he is sentenced for pretty much the remainder of his natural life, being 57 years. So that is a mouthful, but it is all pretty much true of what happened. Amazing set of circumstances, how somebody from a homeless aspect or a nomad aspect can go from being on the Jimmy Kimmel show to basically behind bars for 60 odd years. It's a crazy documentary. As I said, I'm not gonna rate it But in terms of something that is pretty crazy to watch in terms of what went on there, it is definitely worth a watch. So be sure to tune into that on Netflix. So thank you for tuning in for my review for the Hatchet Wielding Hitchhiker. And as always, I will catch you on the Menjay.
Part of me wondered what actually happened that day in Fresno. Was this him being the hero or not?
Smash!
Hitting somebody in the head with a hatchet 3 times, blunt side or not, is violent.
Smash!
When it comes to a certain situation of pressure, you either become a diamond or you get crushed.
Smash!
So there you have it, the documentary for the Hatchet Wielding Hitchhiker. Be sure to check it out on Netflix. So do me a massive favor, smash on that subscribe button and join the DMR crew. Cheers.